You are listening to the View From My Window podcast, where life is explored through positive Christian thoughts. Everyone has a window, and each window has a different view. Here, I hope you will find the view to be encouraging, inspirational, and useful as you walk through your daily journey. Sometimes our view may not always be clear or focused, but through God, I hope you can have a much better perspective. So open up your window, your hearts, and your thoughts to the encouraging view from God's perspective. Well, hello, friends. I'm Laura, your host of this podcast, and I welcome you. Today's episode number 33 is entitled God Moments, because I believe every moment, every breath, every thought, and everything we do can be a God moment. So let me start out by saying that there is no replica of the moments we are given. They come and go in an instant, and if we don't live each day to its fullest potential, we simply miss out. But this doesn't mean we can't learn from it. We absolutely can. Once a moment is gone and we come to the realization we could have and should have done better, then that missed opportunity has become a learning experience. It's like a raindrop I saw several years ago when I was watching the rain fall. It was a raindrop waiting to fall from a tree limb. It just sits and waits. The moment only lasts so long before it moves on. Once it does, there's no getting it back. The raindrop falls but can never return to that moment before. So when you find yourself on the edge of a moment, much like that raindrop, when it passes and that moment ends, God sees you. And when you find yourself much like that drop of rain, not knowing how you got there, nor knowing how to stop the fall, realize this. God not only sees you, but knows you and understands you before, during, and after the fall. No, we cannot go back to the exact moments where we once were, but I do believe God gives us second chance moments, not for His sake, but for ours. If we could just remember that no situation will ever go away until it teaches us what we need to learn. Sometimes, in your not so good days, we will find some good days. Maybe some even awesome days. On those days when you might be struggling, remember those good days, those awesome days. Carry them with you. Keep those days in your most deepest thoughts as a reminder that you cannot enjoy the good without the bad. Better days are ahead. With fall finally here, it reminds me that nothing stays the same for very long, does it? In the blink of an eye, change will occur. Some things may have a faint familiarity, but then the deluge of transition shifts with the winds, leaving us with the new surroundings. If that is not happening, then life is not being lived to its fullest. Every moment we have is a God moment, even in those seemingly mundane, ordinary moments. God gives us opportunities to do better and be better. In those moments when you find yourself overwhelmed, discouraged, and distracted, stop and ask God, "What do I need to learn from this?" He will answer you. It might not be that very moment, but He will answer you. It might not be what you want to hear, but He will answer you. Deuteronomy 14:2 says that you have been set apart, a chosen people for His purpose. We have been chosen for His purpose. Proverbs 19:21 says that you can make many plans, but the Lord's purpose will prevail. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know that the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." And John 13:7 says, Jesus says, "You don't understand now what I'm doing, but someday you will." I don't think for a moment that the Word of God and these scriptures are here just for our entertainment. These words are for us, for our learning, for our benefit. The Word of God is alive and active to bring a better perspective of who we are and whose we are. So let's open our windows, let's open our hearts, let's open our thoughts to the encouragement from God's Word. And I hope this leaves you with a better perspective. I hope you've been inspired. I hope that if you have not had a good day, that one of these verses have lifted you. I hope you will pick your Bible up and you will open it and see what God says. He's talking to you. All you have to do is open it up and listen. And until next time, I love you guys.